If the data change in your backend or in your database, then it will straight away reflect in your front end. Yeah, election is coming. But instead of arguing about who's our next prime minister, we're going to pick like a better topic. What is the best programming language? So this is a voting app where basically what it does is I have a pie chart showing all the languages, and then if I vote in any of the languages, the backend vote should increment, and then it should reflect in the oh Python is not good. Sorry. That's why this is a hard question.
Let's go vote.
Okay, so okay, because we are implementing our mission group for moving.
It's working.
Okay, I need to refresh. Okay.
Yeah. I mean the backend is
the backend is working well.
So we can debug for you.
Okay, so I swear to God, I'll try that. So basically, like, okay, so I'll try later when the video is not on. So basically, you can see here when my application launch, it will connect to two different endpoints. The first one is the API endpoint. So the API endpoint, this is an HTTP endpoint for GraphQL. So you can see here a request for all the votes from the backend. So we will reach the HTTP endpoint and then get all the data. And then after I click one of each of these buttons, then it will update. It will update each of these votes. And then here you can see, like, if you have a web socket connection, then my file is also connected to the GraphQL subscription. Then anything happens, I can push the event to the file. Now I'll try this later. So I'm using the Google Windows 5.2, so it comes with Webpacker, and then let's start. Some of you might be familiar with GraphQL, some are not. It's just a query language, so you can use it as an alternative to REST. So instead of having a lot of endpoint, we actually declaratively declare the data that you want from your screen, and then the GraphQL backend will resolve that result to you. I'll show some of the codes later. So there are many operations you can use, but in this particular application, we just use the query, which will request all the votes at the beginning, and then the subscription every time the data changes at the backend. ActionCable is a WebSocket implementation for Rails. You can use multiple adapters, but the most famous one is usually people use Redis. And then for ActionCable, for using this GraphQL, you can create a GraphQL channel to connect with your front end. For those who are not familiar with WebSocket, it is a full duplex connection between the server and the client. So you just initiate one connection and then you can send data back and forth. And then I also use something called Apollo on the front end. which is the like to remove all the boilerplate of handling the subscription on the front end. It is very popular GraphQL client, so I can show like when we use a portal, you can see there is like it comes with a query like query interface, and then you can see all the data that's being cached. So it comes with something similar to Redux, so you don't need a separate store to handle all the data. So you get the data from the server, you will cache on the client, and then for example, I subscribe to a new data, it will resolve it and then update as necessary. And then of course I use React to handle like the changes in the interface. And then I use React on Rails and then Webpacker to handle it. So this is how it works in summary. Like I actually like tried to research this because we wanted to build like a notification feed. So the notification feed should respond to like, for example, okay, people like your photo, then it should show in my notification, right? And then, okay, people remove it from this group, then I should be able to see that. So, and we want that to happen even though the user doesn't refresh the page. So, in this case, for example, you already have a GraphQL backend. That is the regular HTTP request response, but we can also create like a different channel for you to handle the subscription between the client and the subscription. In our case, it's just the graph. Okay, so what are the use cases for this? For example, like we have a notification feed, or we have a location tracking where, like for example, you are in GoGet or in Uber, and then you want to update, okay, where's the driver's location? And then you update that frequently, and then the other clients will get broadcasted with that information. And then you can also notify updated data. For example, GitHub uses this a lot. Like for example, you are reviewing a PR, and then suddenly it says, oh, okay, refresh your page because the content is updated or something like that. So if you see the tab, you can see the WebSocket section is sending all these notifications update. And then there's also a question, when to use subscription over calling, which is like calling the HTTP endpoint multiple times in an expected interval. So one example is if it's like the scale of the data is large, but then the subsequent updates are very small, like it's just change here and there. So you can use subscription over calling for that. And then another one is you really care about the latency of the notification. You want the client to get that instant without like waiting a specific interval for calling. Yeah, and this is all my references. Are you guys interested in seeing the code? Or
what's your AWS keys, please?
It's not Bitcoin. That's like. Okay. So basically, the index page we just show two different components, the feed and the chart. So each one of these in Rails 5, this will go into JavaScript components folder. So you can build your own like JavaScript component there. And then I just create over all the candidates of the voting, and then just update their votes. And then if you're using GraphQL, you need to define a new type, which is called the subscription type. So this field will be referred as an event when you actually trigger or broadcast from ActionCable later. So it is actually very straightforward and easy to use with this is my books controller. So I just find the candidate, I increment the value, and then I use something called subscription trigger latest book count. You guys remember I had the type subscription latest book count, right? So I can trigger this from the back end, and then the query on the front end will reflect that. Okay, so if you use GraphQL Ruby, you will have to define a different schema, because GraphQL is kind of like type query language, so you need to define, but you can resolve that to a model or an object later.
Sure, so how does that look
like? Okay.
I don't know why.
I think it's your like this.
Sending back the data. So I had this problem during like development, but it was because I wasn't using Redis. So I just
used the
Redis should be turned on now because
yeah.
So and you can see in the logs that it actually broadcast. So you can see like streaming from that account and then it is subscribed. But when an event happens in the backend, yeah, so it is similar problem what I had during the development. So what we should see is like we receive a data from here.
Okay, isn't that like says data now? Can
you work that? So the initial state would be that like.
You're saying it worked before.
Yeah. Just now before the
situation happened.
Can you try
it? I think we go with T. No, I mean like if it happened.
Does it matter that
because
just now I saw some error with no content being returned. Does it matter that the response for those?
No, actually, because actually the important part is this part. Like it broadcasts to the event with the ID of the new vote, and then it should send back to because I had this problem with development, but because I wasn't using Redis, using async, which is the default one, and then the creator, like the maintainer of GraphQL Ruby, said like that was definitely a problem with async. So once I change it to Redis, then it worked just fine until we came to Shalom. I think I don't want to waste like 4 more of your guys' time. Sorry!